when you're set up to follow your passion, mm-hmm. even though it's in the back burner,
yeah.
you're always wanting to go back to pursue that passion. Mm-hmm. But I knew it had something to do with the restaurant world or the kitchen. One day, I was just watching Chef's Table, and I saw this episode, and I think everybody knows him, he's Kagan, and for some reason, his episode just resonated with me so much that I sent him an email asking, like, you know, I'm in my late 30s, just gonna say yes to me, but I just really poured my heart out there and asked him if I can stage in his restaurant, and for whatever reason, a miracle happened, he said yes. So I went there, I stashed for 2 months, and my husband said to me, if you come back, you still want to run a restaurant, then maybe you really want to run a restaurant.
For the curious, her pseudonym, Mrs. Saldo, is actually Chef Rhea Rizzo's testament to her favorite red Zinfandel wine called Saldo.
So the Asian tasting menu, it's really a culmination of my journey through Asia. So you're gonna find Peranakan, Indonesian, Chinese, Japanese, and finally Filipino later in the petit fours. But to start you off, what you have in front of you is crispy potatoes with cream tinapa, ikura, matcha powder, and chives. Okay, so for your next snacks, on your right-hand side, you're gonna start off with my rendition of No Signboards white pepper crab, but I turn it into a sandwich. In the middle, you have a beef tenderloin tart with Marnay, which is bechamel with Gruyere cheese, crispy dillies, cilantro, and a mango veil on top. And then finally, you have a cashew meringue with brown butter banana jam, braised pork Shanghai style, and togarashi on top.
As we were enjoying the meal, we can't help but feel cozy and invited in this space. What more when we have special people around us? But for now, we are really enjoying Mrs. Saldo's company and her stories on how she turned her dreams into reality.
When it was just the brick wall and the tiles, my husband was looking at me like, what did you do? Like, trust in me. It's in my head,
yeah.
So I try to like just take it out and then I do it and like, okay, that makes sense. So for your fish course, it's our Thai fish curry with air-flown hamachi. You get the fish whole, we fillet ourselves, and then I think the best way to respect the fish is to just serve it with a very light curry sauce. And it's best eaten with sticky rice. So for your chicken course, you have a Indonesian chicken satay with bumbu bali peanut sauce. Bumbu bali is like a rempah. They put it in their marinades, in their satays, in their sauces. And I paired it with a Shanghai fried rice, but I made it more Pinoy by adding the red salted egg and tomatoes. For your meat course, you have a Peranakan lamb curry, blue pea coconut rice, kaffir pineapple, fried shallots, peanuts, and a cucumber cilantro salad.
So this is really your baby.
Yes.
Everything, every piece of material in this place is like thought of by you.
Yeah.
Everything. So tell us about building this place.
On paper, it sounds ridiculous because I said I want to bring in the Peranakan atmosphere of the paintings, the art, their very rich, vibrant culture. And also you have the industrial, unfinished look of San Francisco, of the bakery.
Yes.
So I think in my head, I am so in love with all of these places. Mm-hmm. I love the culture, I love the food, I love the design.
Yes.
So how do you bring those back here in one area, in one place, and then somehow they kind of melt together?
Yeah.
You're gonna be having a pistachio baklava with white chocolate ganache and pink peppercorns. And our honey buns, it's served with coconut ice cream, langka, and kaffir caramel, and peanuts.
Okay.
Correct.
You know?
And the most rewarding part for me was I had a guest and I said hi to them after the tasting menu, and they said, your food brought us to places we've never been to.
Yeah.
And I thought that was like, oh my God, that's exactly how I want them to feel.
Yes.
Right? The emotions of being in the, you know, like being just inspired by this many cultures.
Pinoy Petit Fours. really inspired by what I love eating as desserts when I was, you know, in my childhood.
What does this remind me of?
I'll tell you the inspiration behind it. Peach mango pie. How can you turn it into a chocolate?
It's exciting to see this lush escape is expanding with a wine cellar and a bakery soon to unveil. Mrs. Saldo's story is weaved from passion, hope, and learning. Dining here is allowing your palate to travel around the world with a wide variety of cuisines from different cultures while enjoying the lush greenery and eclectic decor. All of these together are made for Mrs. Saldo's guests to create wonderful experiences with the people they love most.